Classroom Screen is a free site that helps you quickly organize your lessons and puts classroom management tools at your fingertips. It gives you a timer, stopwatch, visual cues, sound level monitor, random name picker, and more from the same screen. You can embed any videos or Google Slides that you plan to show students, along with maybe a picture schedule. This will put everything on one screen, so transition between activities are quick and you have your visuals easily accessible anytime you need them. So here I've launched Classroom Screen and I get this nice background that's ready for me to fill in with classroom tools and materials. If you look down at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the widget bar, and this first widget will let you change that background. So you can either pick one of the backgrounds that Classroom Screen provides you, including some of these that are actually animated, so you can watch a campfire or watch waves roll in or a waterfall come down, or you can have solid backgrounds to really give your widgets some high contrast and make it less distracting. You can even upload your own backgrounds if you want. So next to this background widget, you have the poll widget. Now, this can be a really nice interactive tool to gather feedback from your students. So students can either come up to the interactive board or computer and pick their poll answer, or they can send responses with their own device. You could show them a QR code to help them quickly get to this joinclassroomscreen.com. Or again, they can just come up to your interactive whiteboard and choose their answer. One nice way to use this, one convenient use for this could be to check in with students to see what zone of regulation they're in. So it would be nice if for that, that these faces were the right colors, but they aren't exactly. So instead you can use the multiple choice poll. And then these colors happen to be the right colors in the right order. So you could just type in for your question, what zone are you in? And for your answers, you could just type in the color names. And you can see you have some other options in the settings here, so that students just use their devices to vote, or they use just buttons on the screen, or they use their device, that's what remote means, and buttons on the screen. And then when students are done voting, you can choose what kind of a chart type will appear, and you can change all the colors. So let's call that good enough for now, and we'll set that up there. So now, as students walk into the room, you can have them check in. As they click on the buttons, you'll notice the chart up on top is going to change. Now the bummer is there's no name assigned to responses. So you either have to just take a mental note when students come to the board, or you have to be happy with an anonymous Snapchat of the class's response in general, which could be really good for formative feedback if you're asking them something related to the content. Now, the exciting part about all of these widgets is that you can resize them and place them wherever you want on the screen, as well as if you go to this three-dot menu, you can choose to spotlight each widget. And so then that is the only widget that you see on the screen until you go ahead and exit out of full screen mode. So that's what that spotlight means. It's going to bring that particular widget up to full screen. All right, I'm going to close out of my poll widget, and next up is the random name picker. So this is nice if you like to randomly assign classroom jobs or randomly call on students. The random name picker is a quick way to do that. You can create your name list by going to the settings up at the top there, and then where it says choose list, you can see I already made one list. But if you wanted to create your own, you would go right into Edit My Lists, and then those name lists are available anytime you launch Classroom Screen. Keep in mind that this doesn't have to be just a name list. It could be a vocabulary review list or a list of movement activities that students will do during a brain break, so that every time you spin the generator, it gives you a new vocabulary word to review, or it gives you that new activity to complete. This could be used for all sorts of things outside of just student names. So that was our random name widget. Next, we have the QR code generator. So if you want a quick way for your students to get to a particular site with their device, maybe it's a mystery science lesson, any other site you want them to visit, you just paste that link right here. I'm just going to grab this one from Mystery Science. I'm going to say share, and I'm going to copy that student link. I'm going to paste it in and say generate QR code. Now when students scan that with their device, they'll jump right to that site. Next up is our sound level widget, and you can see it's working already. I'm gonna just mute my microphone there so that we don't keep getting interrupted. But if you want to help students monitor the sound level in the classroom, you can use this widget. It's great if your class has a tendency to get too loud during group work, or if your students who don't talk loud enough for others to hear, you could also use this so that they can see that monitor going up and down and help self-monitor how loud they're talking. Keep in mind that you can adjust the maximum noise down here before that bell goes off. Next to our sound level widget is our image widget. This will allow you to bring in any image, including maybe something like a visual schedule or a first then schedule that you've made in another program, like maybe BoardMaker. And so to bring in another image, you're just going to say open settings, and then you can drag a file in there, or you can upload a file. I'm just going to grab this picture schedule. And now again, I can make that as big as I want so that maybe it takes up the majority of my board. The next widget down there is both a text widget and a draw widget. Both of those are pretty self-explanatory. But the text widget is really great for entering your learning intention. And now most of these widgets, if you go to that three-dot menu again, have the option to show this particular widget across all screens. And so you can pin it there. Because as you maybe notice down at the bottom, you can choose to add screens so that you might have one for each class period or one for each subject, maybe one for each student. So next to the text and draw widgets, you have these work symbols that are just here ready for you to use. This gives you the option to display symbols reminding students of noise level expectations. So if you want it completely quiet, you can leave that up there. If it's okay for students to whisper, you could allow that visual up. You also have options for it's okay to ask a neighbor, and then it's okay to work together. So just kind of that constant visual of what that expectation is. You could pair that with your sound level monitor. You could have those right next to each other so that if this one says silent, you don't want to see that sound level monitor moving. All right, so next to those work symbols is this traffic light widget. And of course, lots of uses for that. You could have green mean there's lots of time to work on the task you're doing. You could have yellow mean it's time to start wrapping up what you're doing. And red meaning it's time to stop. You need to put everything away. Lots of different uses for that traffic light. Next to the traffic light widget is the timer widget. And of course, timers always come in handy. If we go into settings here, we can see that we have the option to show a red indicator when time is almost up, which is really nice. The other thing we have is the option to show the timer in the browser tab itself. So right now that's chosen. And so if we start the timer, and you can see now that the time that's left is up in my browser tab, so that if I do go out to another tab, I can still keep tabs on the time that's left. So that is the timer, and next to the timer is the clock. Now you'll notice you have the hour hand, the minute hand, and the second hand. So this can be a really good teaching tool. If you size it just right, you won't be able to see the digital time below, and then you could resize to see that digital time. So that could be a nice learning tool for students, and then they could be checking their work, whether they knew what time it was or not. But also in settings, what's nice about the clock is you can add alarms. The other nice thing about the clock is you have the ability to set alarms. And so if you add an alarm, might be that certain events start or end at the same time every day. And so every time you launch Classroom Screen, you want that alarm to go off at those particular times. So you could give that alarm a description if you want, but just put in the time and then say, save this alarm to my profile, and then save alarm. And now every time you launch Classroom Screen, those alarms will go off for you. So that was the clock. And then next to the clock, we can click on this more widgets icon. And now we have another whole row down here of them. We have a calendar. And what's nice about this calendar is I get the full calendar view here. I can even click through to different months. But if I make this widget more narrow, I get a nice big today is and the date down there. So after my calendar, next up is dice, which always come in handy. And if you click on the settings, you can see you have lots of different choices for the dice. And after the dice, we have something called embed. Embed is a really nice feature because it allows you to add anything you can get an embed code for. So example, this is where you could publish a Google Slides file. You just grab the embed code and put it right into your classroom screen. So now when you're ready to go through these slides, you can either just resize them and make them bigger, click through them, or you can spotlight them, make it the only widget students are seeing. Lots of nice options. So you could have all your Google Slides right here, ready to be opened up and viewed. You can also embed Google Docs or Sheets. And if you're not sure how to publish a Google file so that you can get that embed code, I'll put a link to a video on how to do that in this video description. So let's look at the rest of our widgets here. We also have a group maker. So this is great if you have a larger class and want to randomly assign students to a group. Just go into settings and choose one of your name lists over here on the left and choose how many and choose the number of groups and adjust any of those other settings that you want to. So next up is a stopwatch, which is great if you need to time how long it takes a student to do a particular task. You have that stopwatch there. And next to the stopwatch is the webcam. And you might wonder what good that does. Well, webcams can be turned into document cameras, and so you could show a book or other printed materials on your classroom screen. And next to the webcam is the video widget. So this makes it really easy to embed any YouTube video here that you want to show during class. So if I just grab a link to a YouTube video, can go in here and press Control V on my keyboard and then say play video. And now my YouTube video is embedded right here and I just hit play and it's going to start playing. So lots and lots of possibilities. So let's just turn this screen over here. You can see that I went in and made this particular screen with a class schedule and my learning target. And now instead of a schedule like this that you brought in with that image widget, you could also just put all your activities in order, right? So students just know that, okay, this is the order of the things we're going to do today. First, we're going to check in. And so when you're ready to do that, you can spotlight this. They can check in. You can close this out. Now you could even do a nice countdown if you want to get rid of that widget so that students know, okay, these are the ones that we have left. And they know that maybe when they get to the end, there's something, a preferred activity there at the end that they're working for. So again, just lots and lots of possibilities with this tool. I hope you enjoy using it.